Alright, so we are going to see the software Vagrant on the virtual environment. You're going to do a project in VirtualBox and how to connect it to your personal browser. So first you'll need to do some installations, VS Code. So it's pretty easy to install. Just go on their website. This is the website, and depending on the which kind of computer you have, if it is a Windows, Linux, or a Mac OS, just download it and you follow the instruction and you get the software. The second one to install will be VirtualBox. So the same process, go into the VirtualBox website. Let's go to the website here. Perfect, so VirtualBox, download it. So depending on the which OS you have, if it is a Windows, Linux, or any other OS, you just download it. And the last one, you need to also install Vagrant, go in their website. So you are gonna go here, vagrantapp.com, downloads. So Mac OS and all the other Linux different OS's. So me, I'm using Windows, so I'm gonna use Vagrant 64 bits for Windows. You're gonna create a folder for your project and put the Vagrant file in it. Let's see the folder I've created already. So here is my folder. So there will be only this is my desktop. I created a folder called Vagrant and the Vagrant file it's inside of it. So after doing my download, I just put the Vagrant file inside this folder. All the other files, I just added them later on. You'll see how I'm gonna use them later on in the tutorial. So using VS Code that we have downloaded before, we are gonna open the Vagrant file and we're gonna do some different modifications. The first one, the config.vm.box, going to let Ubuntu install. So we're gonna install Ubuntu. I'm using Ubuntu 20.04, so that's the focal 64. So we're gonna change this line, which is, yes, this one, Ubuntu focal 64, it's Ubuntu 20.04. That's the latest. All right. So now we are here in VS Code. That's what is inside the file, the Vagrant file. So this is the one I changed. So initially it was something else. I just changed it from Ubuntu Focal 64. And we can also add some extra hosts and guest ports to be able to play with it later on. Those are the doors between the VM, the virtual machine, which is in your virtual box, and your local environment. It means that your computer, the one you're using. So I'm doing some connection between port 9000, 9001, and I'm going a special one, 9003 and 9004. So the example here is that the port 9003 is the guest, and the 9004, it's your host computer. I'm gonna use it later on just to show you how it works. So where is it? It's here, it's line 19. That's where I added the ports. 9000, the guests, 9000, the host, 9001, the guests, 9001. The host, and you can see, you can give a name to your VM. And you can add also some memory. So here I'm just using 1024, but it can be 2048. Just using the, you can add some memory like that. 1024 will be enough for this tutorial. It's enough for us today. Yes. Alright. So here is the sync folder. That's a folder which is going to be shared between the VM and the local computer. I'm going to talk about it later on. And after, you can also add some extra script that you are going to provision, the provision scripts, if you want to install anything from the initial stage. So like Nginx, Ansible, or any other behavior that you want your environment to have. There are different commands that you are going to use. So commands, very important. Vagrant up as the first command. So when you do a vagrant up, you have to do it from the folder where your vagrant file is. So you have to navigate in your command line and be in that folder. If you plan to install more stuff, you should put all the stuff next to that vagrant file. So you've seen that my vagrant file, I have so many things around it, is because I'm using it to install it. So here, for example, GDK, that's the file for Oracle, Java 11 also. This is all for Java, Java applications. And the application here we're going to use later on will be the one that I downloaded from GitHub, the clinic, the pet clinic tutorial. So here I'm going to just open PowerShell. Right, so PowerShell is open. Let's navigate. We said we have to be in the right folder. So here we're not in the right folder. Let's cd back to the root and let's go to users. My user here is W10, and the desktop, and desktop I mean the vagrant folder. So let's see what is inside. So that's what we have inside, exactly the same. So we're in the right folder. We have the vagrant file, all the Java installation stuff, and the clinic project that I downloaded from GitHub. So you can see they're all similar. So let's do a vagrant up from here. So now it's gonna make the connection. You see the Ubuntu Focal has been installed. Now it's asking us which bridge, which network you want to use for the bridge. For me, it's the one, the Intel R Ethernet connection. You see here we have the 9000 port, 9001, 9004. It has created an SSH username and the private key. So we're gonna use this connection SSH later on to go in our virtual environment from our host computer. So now it's still creating this connection. It's bridging between both. So the connection has been aborted, is retrying. Okay, now we connect it to the VM. It's gonna be enabling all the configurations, mounting our Ubuntu. And here it's telling us that we can run a vagrant provision or use the dash dash provision to force provisioning. So we were just gonna use vagrant. Here you see we did vagrant up. So now we're gonna do vagrant provision. It's to enable the script in the vagrant file, having all extra installations and or Yes, so whenever we change the vagrant file, we also need to do a vagrant provision, just to update. So you see the provision here, config.vm.provision, using the shell. So I'm just typing some shell commands. So to install Ansible, for example, Nginx, or to add some extra abilities, like here being able to see with netstat. Check the port and what's running on it, because this is not natively installed in the virtual machines. So just all the commands. It's very important also to not forget to add the yes dash dash yes or just dash y. This is gonna, because during the installation it's gonna ask you if you want to use some extra memory, or because it's going to take some space, so you need to validate by saying yes. So don't forget to add those dash dash yes or dash y. So let's vagrant provision, and now all the installations are going to start running. So the shell we want in that line that I just showed you, and now all the dependencies are going to be installed one by one. Alright, this is Nginx. For the people who already know how it looks like, this is Nginx when it's connected. The daemon is on, it's live, and it's active. So now let's do a vagrant SSH. Doing this, we're gonna be able to connect with the virtual machine. So now we are inside the virtual machine. You see, inside the Ubuntu 20.4 that we just installed. So we can just use it like a normal Ubuntu computer. And here it shows you the bridge IP address and the memory usage. You get all the information here. So you see, we're using less than 50%, we're at 45%. Alright, so this is the bridge, the network. So that's what we've done now, is to connect the terminal to the virtual machine using the private key that we created when we did Vagrant up. So now we are in our Linux Ubuntu in the virtual machine. We can work from there as if you are in a computer. So let's just some CD and go to the root. So you see at the root we have this vagrant folder. That's the vagrant folder that we have in our computer, in the Windows one. That's the one we're sharing together. So don't confuse, there's a confusion that people make, because there's another one here which is in the home folder. It's called also vagrant. But this one is not the one that we share with the root folder. So just let's check. Go into the vagrant. This is the one from the home. You see, doing an ls, there's nothing inside. But when we go to the one in the root and we do ls, we're gonna find all the different files that we had in our Windows folder. So that's where you can bridge between the virtual machine and your host machine by sharing documents through this folder. It's pretty easy. So you see we have the same files. Vagrant file, here all the GDK stuff. Yes. So everything is the same here. So, what's coming next? So this is what I just showed you. So this brings you to the root of your Ubuntu virtual machine. And this is the folder shared between your virtual machine and your local computer. So just beware, this folder can be named the same, Vagrant. Don't create confusion, because in your home directory, there's another vagrant directory accessible. on the home directory. So next, we're gonna just do, we're gonna stop doing the comments and we're gonna go to the next one. Here's the folder, you see Vagrant, but you can name it something else. If you don't want to have this confusion, just we could create another name of folder to avoid any confusion. Okay, I'm just gonna leave it Vagrant as it is, but you can just name it something else. Okay, those commands, we're gonna see them later on before shutting down everything. Now the challenge is to open a project using the VM and SSH connection. See the project from our local Chrome browser. So we're gonna launch the project inside the VM, but we're gonna be able to access to it from our Chrome browser in our host computer, in our local computer. So this is how to install GDK and launch the Java application. So we have to make sure that the tar.gz file is in the same folder. It's in the folder where the Vagrant file is. So we have to copy that one. Copy it to the var cache. So in the Ubuntu, we have to copy it here. Just let's go in the Ubuntu and show you where it should be. So even when you read the tutorials online, you can be confused in where to put your files and where it should be copied. So here I'm just going to show you. I'm navigating from the root to var and after cache and after RMB in cache. I'm going to ls and show you. I'm going to cd to oracle gdk11. And you see inside we have our, we have copied this this file gdk11 on Linux, the tar.gz has been copied to this folder. It's very important to do it that way. So after we're gonna just install it, we find a way to set a variable. So we need to set a environment variable telling where is the home for Java. So it's user lib gvm and the Java 11 OpenGDK MD64. So we're just gonna cd from the root to etc. Oh no, okay, user library. I'm just gonna show you first where is it. GVM. And you see here we have it here. So now let's go to the etc environment. So that's the environment variable that we need to add. So we're gonna sudo nano straight away into the etc environment. So now we're inside and you can see here we have saved this environment variable. Okay, so don't forget to put the quotes around it. That's good. So if you got that set, you'll be able to launch. You need to source it. Don't forget to source the environment variable, and after you sudo apt update, do that upgrade, and you launch an application on a port that you have made available to bridge from a VM to the host. So So this is how it's the format of it, and this is how we're gonna write it down. So you see here, that's the clinic. This is the project called clinic. So now we're inside. Inside we have another folder called target. Let's just open it from here. I have it open already, that's why. So this is the target one, already open. Here, target, and that's the one we want to open, the .jar file. Spring Pet Clinic 2.5.jar. And we're gonna serve it on port 9001. So this one here, we're gonna use this port. So if you use this port 9001 in the VM, we're gonna use the same port in the host to be able to see the project open. Alright, so here we inside the Vagrant folder. Now we are going to navigate inside the clinic project, cd to the clinic. Now we're in, we just put our command, sudo java. So java, we're going to launch the java application. That's the jar file, which is here on the server. Sorry, the server is going to be served on port 9001. So there's the pet clinic launching. Everything looks good for the moment. That's fine. We're just gonna see when it tells us that the port is served. Initializing, exposing, and now the Tomcat started on port 9001. So we started the application. So now what we're gonna do? This is our browser, which is in our local computer. We're gonna navigate to localhost 9001 and see what's gonna happen. Localhost 9001. A beam, and the connection has been made. So now we can see and navigate in. Here, no, not this one. So just to show you that we can make the connection between both. Why is it 9001 and 9001 the other in the VM as well? It's because that's what we have set in the Vagrant file. Home, errors. So this works. The project is not done yet. You can see that there's a lot of stuff missing, but you can use it to just for your training. So now Control C, just go out, we CD. ETC. So we're gonna go ETC Nginx sites available. Where is it? Okay, sites available. So you remember we've installed Nginx. So here, default. So we're gonna sudo nano init. We'll be able to do some modifications. As you can see here, I changed the port to 9003. So initially, Nginx is listening on port 80 when you install it, so it will be written port 80. But why did I change it to port 9003? Is to not expose this port 80. You can actually customize it and change it to any port that you want to set. So 9003 is the one I set, and you can see also that in the Vagrant file, that's the port I've set from the VM. So here Nginx is gonna serve on port 9003 from the VM, and bridging to 9004 on the local computer, on the host computer. So I changed the port number just to show you that it can be different port numbers if you want. Because before, for the pet clinic project, I did 9001 to 9001, but you can do whatever you want. Let's see. This is good. It's saved. Here. So if I use the 9003, and I launch it, nothing happened, you see? We don't have any connection. That's normal, because it's 9004 that has been set to work. And here we should see the Nginx page. You can see here, 9003, from the guest to the VM, to 9004, the host. So to call on that connection, I need to connect to 9004 on the host computer, your local computer. So guest is the VM, set Nginx here at port 9003. Alright. And host is our local computer, set to connect on port 9004. So now let's do it again for 9004. When you see, we can see the page of Nginx, the connection is made. That means from this page, you can put any website that you want, and you can launch it like that. Or any services that you want to serve. Here we are. This is done. So we've accomplished the mission. We've opened the project Pet Clinic using our Ubuntu virtual machine. So now let's go back and a bit and see how to stop everything. So we're going to use exit to close the SSH connection and go back to our local terminal. So now our PowerShell is connected, is in Ubuntu. Exit and we disconnect it. We're back into the PowerShell, normal one. So our local computer, we're not anymore inside the VM, but the VM is still running. So we can do Vagrant Alt or Vagrant Suspend to stop the Vagrant virtual machine instance, or Vagrant Destroy. This is to stop the instance, but also to get rid of the virtual machine. It's gonna get rid of everything, so we'll have to start over from the beginning. So here we might use Vagrant Alt because I still need it. I don't want to destroy it. Vagrant Alt, let's do that. So you see it's shutting down. So now the server inside, it's not working anymore. We shut down. Okay, so now this is done. Good. So whenever you want to start again, you do a Vagrant app, that's to relaunch the VM with what is only the Vagrant file, and you do a Vagrant provision again to you just reinstall everything that you wanted to install in it. So for example, add the installation. GDK, that will be a kind of exercise for you. If you want to play with it, just you're gonna incorporate the installation of GDK directly into the Vagrant file. So, for example, I add the installation of GDK directly in your Vagrant file under Vagrant Earth and Vagrant App and Vagrant Provision. Get it installed from the beginning. So you try this exercise. Alright. Well, good luck and hope you've enjoyed this little tutorial around Vagrant. Now you have everything you want to be able to work from a virtual machine and not use all the resources of your computers and be able to work remotely.